Weston-super-Mare. In the rain. I don't know if you know it, do you? A Victorian watering hole off the M5 that looks like it never quite made it into the 20th century, but did what it could to resist for a while before finally giving way and swallowing everything that metal and concrete could do to it, until little was left but the silly smile of a seaside town that had lost its way and embraced the triple towers of modern Britain. Greed, vomit, and chip paper. But I'm getting ahead of myself. First, how I got into this mess. I was traumatized the day my father's brakes failed on the M4, and he mounted a cheese lorry from behind, taking my mother with him. Traumatized, I say, not so much by their deaths, our relationship had only been so-so, you understand, as by my father's last will and testament.
I leave all my worldly goods in temporary trust to my dear mother Maria, who will act as my executor.
What?
Who will act as my executor for 5 years, at which time monies will be shared equally between my children.
Can this be right?
Subject to certain special conditions.
Special conditions?
Max, settle down.
I was upset, you see, very upset, and lacking my sister's sang-froid.
It's in the will, sir.
What does this mean?
We'll talk to Granny, Max.
And as we stood there under the tick of Granny's ormolu clock, amid the suffocating gloom of her mahogany furniture, I felt like a child again, about to be told that for his own good his pocket money had been cut.
How can I put this?
Granny.
Max's outburst today.
Yes.
To poor Benson.
Quite.
Although not unamusing.
Really?
Was inappropriate.
I'm sure he'd like to apologise.
Would you shut up, Katrin?
Would you mind controlling yourself?
Can I finish?
Of course.
Which leads me to the terms of my dear son, your dear father's will.
And to an outsider the details would have seemed surprising. I was to keep in work, support myself, and generally behave, but specifically, I was to be nice to my sister Katrin for 5 years, and she to me. Whoever broke it would be out of the will, to be judged by Granny. Yeah, that's going to take a bit of explaining. How do you feel about flashbacks? Katrin and I are about 10 years old. We're twins, did I tell you that? My parents often away, Daddy making money, Mummy in bed with strangers. We were often together, that is the point. Granny in charge. And so, of course, we were very close.
What's Toby doing in your pram?
Resting.
He's a cat. Why isn't he out killing birds?
He doesn't approve of violence.
He's a big girl's blouse.
It isn't anything to do with you, Max.
I mean, you wouldn't think, looking at him, you wouldn't think he'd evolved from the proud tiger.
Goodbye, Max. Lovely talking to you.
A confrontation that could only end one way.
Granny!
What is it now?
For that was the evening when Toby tragically passed away. Of course, they blamed me.
Max did it! Max did it!
Max!
I mean, there were no marks on the body. The evidence was circumstantial.
He poisoned him!
Max, come here. Is this true?
No.
Liar.
You want to go for an autopsy? Fine by me. But without a pathologist's report, I'm walking.
Oh, you little monster. Wait till I tell your father.
The point of all this, my card was marked early. Katrin only had to shout my name and I'd be punished. Example, the unfortunate garrotting of her pet parrot, Silky.
Max did it!
Max!
And then, of course, the incident with the bike. A fine spring day. Katrin freewheeling down Welbury Hill.
Look at me, Max!
Her little cheek.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.